Hey, Morningstar, Pastor Mike here. In his press briefing last Friday, President Trump underscored the vital nature of places of worship, announcing that churches should be deemed essential and should be open for worship as long as they meet CDC guidelines. Some of you are wondering how this impacts us here at Morningstar. A couple things. First, hey, we agree with the president. The church is definitely essential and plays a crucial role in helping people navigate all of life, especially in times of a pandemic. Which is why we've not closed the church. We've closed the building, but if anything, Morningstar has expanded our ministries through each of our online offerings, all of which are intended to bless and encourage not only those within our community of faith, but a broader community as well. Second, please understand that President Trump's announcement is generally intended for those 95% of churches which have less than 100 people in worship each weekend, and specifically for those churches located in states that have mandated the closing of houses of worship. Here in Missouri, on the other hand, our governor lifted restrictions on churches prior to the president's announcement, trusting churches to meet social distancing guidelines and do what's in the best interest of that particular congregation. So here's what I want you to hear from me. First and foremost, this is not a political issue for us at all. It's not about agreeing or disagreeing with the president, the governor, or anyone else. It's not a Democrat thing or Republican thing. It's a safety thing. We made the original decision to close our campus before the government mandate, and we will reopen when we feel it's safe for everyone. Second, our leadership team continues to listen to the medical experts and health agencies in our area. Further, I've been in communication with dozens of pastors all across the Midwest, all of whom are trying to solve this puzzle of when to reopen. Everything, as you know, continues to evolve and change almost daily, and we're doing our best to keep current on the latest developments. Third and lastly, we put together an initial draft of how to reopen with a series of phases. But before we finalize it, we want to hear from you. What are your feelings? What are your thoughts? What are your concerns? So we put together a brief survey, just 10 quick questions that'll take just a couple minutes, I promise you. This survey will be open only for 5 days through this Sunday night at midnight, May 31st. So let me urge you, as soon as this is over, stop and complete it now. Hey, I realize that people's opinions on this matter are all across the board. And honestly, no matter what we decide, there are going to be some people who agree and some who disagree. The only thing I ask is that you trust what I say in that we have spent serious amounts of time devoted to prayer and discussion on this issue. This is not something we are taking lightly. We're doing our best to get this right and put the safety of everyone at the top. It's my hope that next week, after we've gathered sufficient data and feedback, we'll be in the position to share those phases I alluded to earlier. Please know, no one is as eager to get back on campus for worship and fellowship as I am. I miss you. I miss your faces and the passion that you bring to worship God and to serve others. Finally, hey, I empathize with those of you who are deeply alone and isolated right now. I can only imagine how difficult it is for you. And if you would benefit from a care or counseling call, please, please let us know. Just pick up the phone, send us an email, and we'll get that set up. Hey, that's all for now. Thanks for watching. And until next week, stay safe, be well, and share Jesus.